Geneva Epps Mosley. Born in 1929 in Crockett, Texas, Geneva Epps Mosley moved to Arizona with her family in 1940. Leonard Duguid Epps and his family settled in southeast Chandler, Arizona, living in a tent. Mr. Duguid worked in the fields alongside other black families in the area. Duguid, as they called him, was the contractor that got the workers to the cotton fields. His daughter, Geneva, at a young age, was responsible for weighing the cotton and paying the workers. Unlike today, the youngsters then couldn't go to school every day. They only went after the cotton picking season was over. During this segregated time, they could only attend the black elementary school in the area. Even though she only attended part-time, Geneva graduated valedictorian of her class. Geneva and her fellow high schoolers had to take an hour and a half bus ride and then walk to the historic Carver High School in downtown Phoenix. She continued to work in the fields, picking and chopping cotton along with working in potatoes, onions, and hay fields. The family eventually settled in the Okemah community in 1945. Shortly thereafter, she married William Mosley Sr. and decided to become a beautician. After finishing Madam C.J. Walker's beauty school, she opened her own shop in Chandler, Arizona, Evelyn's Everidy Beauty Shop. In time, she moved the shop to her home on 40th Street in Okemah. Geneva had a passion for music, who took delight in expressing her emotions through dancing. She was a polished and rhythmic dancer on the dance floor. Geneva always aspired to attend college and become a teacher. She enrolled in the program at Arizona State University. She continued to do hair and even took a job in the college student union as a dishwasher to make ends meet. Working two jobs and raising seven children was a challenge. However, young girls in the community helped with babysitting. Among those lending a hand included Jean Daniels, LaVon Daniels, Inez Owens, Gussie Wooten, and Ethel Daniels. She received her bachelor's in education in 1959 and began to substitute teaching the following year. Shortly thereafter, her teaching skills caught the attention of the Tempe School District, and she was hired as the first African-American teacher in Tempe, Arizona. She would teach for 29 years. During her tenure, this trailblazer earned a master's degree and started her doctorate, but didn't want to leave the classroom for an administrative position, which was usually required having a doctorate degree. Geneva was not only dedicated to teaching students lessons, but life lessons as well. Mrs. Mosley wanted her students to learn about the responsibilities of life after school. She created many projects for her students to apply what they learned in the classroom, from going grocery shopping with their parents to the Penny Saver Brigade. She also hired many of her students to deliver the Penny Saver newspaper in the neighborhood. They would get together and plan how to spend the money they earned. Geneva's teaching talent and education garnered numerous accolades, but none were more important than seeing her students learn and achieve. Along with teaching, she was active in the community, especially the Phoenix chapter of the IBPO Elks of the World. She was a daughter ruler for 3 years, financial secretary for 30 years, and head of the State Education Committee. The committee raised funds for scholarships for high school students. All of this led to her receiving the Grand Honors, the highest award one can receive unless seeking national office. A significant part of her life has always been in the church, since she was a toddler in Texas. She joined Willow Grove Missionary Baptist Church in Okemah under the pastorate of W.M. Hardison in the 1950s and is still an active member today. After retiring, Geneva continued to work as a substitute teacher until 80 years old, and she now resides in Tempe, Arizona.
Education was important to me, so I stress that importance to my students every day. No matter what you choose to do for your future, you will do your best if you enjoy what you are doing. And it all starts right here in the middle school. And students, listen to me. The world owes you nothing but an opportunity. And the sky is the limit. Go for it. I'm sure you can. And you will be.
Time for you.
I know you have a question in your mind, so I'm going to answer it now. Mrs. Mosley is 93 years old.
This 93-year-old lifelong educator carries on the values of education the Okemah community instilled in the children and continues to mentor young people whenever there is an opportunity. Naming a school after an individual requires looking at their record, life, and measuring them according to the educational system, district, school, and community values. The U.S. Department of Education's mission is to promote student achievement and preparation for global competitiveness by fostering educational excellence and ensuring equal access. The mission of Tempe Unified School District: all students will graduate with the skills necessary for success in college, career, and life. The philosophy of the Geneva Epps Mosley School is all means all. The City of Tempe values: people, integrity, respect, openness, creativity, quality, and diversity. The common goal of each entity is to ensure students will have a quality education and embody the skills to succeed as leaders in their country, city, and communities. Mrs. Geneva Epps Mosley has done this as an educator and as a community leader. Mrs. Mosley embodies the Geneva Epps Middle School philosophy, all means all. When she entered the Tempe Unified School District, the students she taught did not look like her. She has exemplified diversity way before it became a catchphrase. She overcame issues from within and outside the system, yet she did not lose focus of her assignment to develop every child to their full potential. She did not just teach the three R's, but how to be competitive in work and society. Many of the students she has taught have gone on to become pillars in their respective communities. Because Mrs. Mosley believed in the education and life of others, she has and continues to use her personal resources to aid in the education of others.